This is a 3D printed reconstruction of the Harbin Cranium, or Dragon Man, that was recently shown to be a Denisovan. Denisovans are an extinct species or subspecies of archaic human that lived from 200,000 to 40,000 years ago in eastern Eurasia. We shared a common ancestor with Denisovans and Neanderthals around 700,000 years ago. The Neanderthal and Denisovan branch of the family left Africa and split into two populations that diverged geographically and genetically over 100,000 years. Neanderthals went west and Denisovans went east, meeting up with the last surviving Homo erectus populations, who likely caused the 4% mystery DNA that shows up in Denisovans. When our sapiens ancestors left Africa 70,000 years ago, they came back into contact with both Neanderthals and Denisovans and interbred with them, carrying a fraction of their DNA with them as they spread across the Earth. Denisovan DNA can be found primarily today in Melanesians, Aboriginal Australians, and Filipino Negritos, with trace amounts of DNA in Native Americans, East Asians, and South Asians. Neanderthal DNA is more widespread and can be found in almost all non-African populations. It is most concentrated in East Asian and European populations. Denisovans were first identified in 2010 by genetic analysis of the bones of seven individuals found in Denisova Cave in the Altai Mountains of Russia. Five of the individuals had mitochondrial DNA structures that differed significantly from known human patterns, and they were given the name of the cave they were found in, which in turn was named after a hermit named Dionysus who lived there. The other two individuals found were a Neanderthal and a Neanderthal-Denisovan hybrid. These remains were only small bone fragments and teeth, and revealed almost nothing about a Denisovan's appearance. It was impossible to identify this group as a new species without more fossils. The Harbin Cranium, or Dragon Man, was found in the sediment of the Songhua River in northeast China, sometime after 1933. The story of its discovery is hazy due to political complications and secrecy, but the Chinese paleoanthropologist Ji Qiang convinced an anonymous individual to donate it to the Hebei Geology University in 2018. In June of 2025, it was announced that 27 of the gene variants found in the skull had only been seen before in the seven Denisovan individuals previously sequenced, and that the Harbin Cranium was almost certainly a Denisovan. We could finally put a face to this mystery hominin. The formal name and classification of this human ancestor is still being debated. It may end up being called Homo Longi, Homo Denisova, or Denisovensis, or it may even be classified as a subspecies of Homo sapiens. A species designation requires a holotype, which is a fossil that has unique physical and morphological features that can be used to categorize future fossil finds. Since Denisovans are known primarily for their DNA, they are still in classification limbo. The Harbin Cranium has been proposed as the species holotype, and we'll soon find out if we have an official new species of hominin and give it an official scientific name. In the meantime, if you are interested in studying the skull for yourself, you can view or download a model of it using the links in the description. I have an original version created using photogrammetry from videos of the CT scans, and a reconstruction I created that fills in the teeth and mandible based on other Denisovan specimens. The skulls are accurately scaled if you want to 3D print your own copy, but don't rely on them for scientific accuracy. Photogrammetry doesn't perfectly replicate an object, so the skull is mostly a display piece. If you enjoy science and want to find ways of experiencing it for yourself at home, please consider subscribing. I'll be making videos on a number of scientific topics that interest me, and I think you'll find them interesting too. If you have suggestions for future videos, please leave a comment below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.